Hello from Menorca Open 2020.
Here, this mountain where you're flying, the southest part of the Monarch is right here. So I always think that it's very nice to see the first Monarchs. When they start arriving, the first Monarchs, you start to arrive. The paraglider pilots arrive exactly the same when the Monarchs come. So we have to learn a lot from this insect that it's amazing that a guy of this size can fly almost 6,000 kilometers. So I think they are the champions of free fly.
And with the words of Vico, welcome to the Monarca Open 2020 in Valle de Bravo, Mexico, where 148 pilots from over 20 countries are competing in cross-country paragliding flight over several tasks. The intention is, as always, to fly as fast as you can while finishing off a predefined task or course over multiple turn points. This involves touching virtual cylinders, which are like a huge radius sitting on course and gives the pilots multiple options of choosing the optimal line and shortest distance of flight. And Matt Hensey and Piero were rocking it on the first day, with Matt taking the lead.
We only had one task yesterday. We have still five got to go. Yesterday was really nice day. I mean, we kind of had a late start of the season, so we had like some rough days on December and January, and yesterday was like perfect clouds. We had strong thermals, but no turbulence at all, so it was a really, really nice day.
So let's get on with the task briefing for today. Task two.
Airborne in seconds, and with beautiful skies at Peñon, the field was taking on the second task, which was a 74 kilometer race to goal. With rougher air than the day before, the task had to be cancelled later during the race. This caused distance points to kick in at a higher scoring level. While Zion and Mitch were racing it, Zion took the lead of task two in the end. Hey, welcome to task three. Let's take a walk at the pit lane, shall we?
Hey, I'm Cass Castro, and I'm so happy to be at Monarca. I'm from Washington, USA.
Hi, my name is Violeta Jimenez. I'm from the US, and I've come to the Monarca for several years. It's one of my favorite places to meet back up with all my friends.
Hi. My name is Gabriela Cruz. I'm working with the organization for the Monarca Open 2020. And we are very happy to host 148 pilots this year.
Hey, hello from Monarca Open 2020. I am Sarah Lockwood. I'm from Santa Barbara, and I'm psyched to be here.
Blue skies, light southwest wind, sounds exciting. Well, it surely is for our field of international pilots racing a 77 kilometers track. This day was dominated by the US pilots. Matt and Mitch were racing constantly head to head, with last year's Monarca champion Mitch winning the day.
Fuck yeah, dude.
There's probably not much to complain about the weather in Mexico. The pilots got blessed with a fourth day of consecutive flying and a huge 95 kilometers race to goal task. Corinna Schwiegershausen from Germany met the podium aspirants after task 4 at the goal field.
I've got the honor today to sit between two top guys of this year's competition. Actually, the winner of last year's competition here, Mitch Riley from the US, and Estefano Salgado, a local pilot here from Valle, who is just showing his very, very best, and also brother of my friend Eric Salgado, who used to fly in the hang gliding national team. So you, congratulations, you did big today.
First
in. And how did you find the conditions here today?
They were rough. It was a lot of pushing into the wind. Mm-hmm. But I was lucky to be in front, and that's it.
Okay. You came in?
I think fourth. Yeah. And it was a good day. It was we had a very technical, interesting part at the beginning. So it paid maybe not to be the first at the start, right, to kind of see how it worked best. And I played that game well. I wasn't the first at the start, so I could see in front of me and got a good climb. And then I came in somewhat early to Espina. And once we got to Espina, it's this convergence area with very strong lift, and we had to go back and forth on it a couple times.
Awesome.
And it was very easy to go fast there.
That's rewarding, isn't it?
Yeah,
it was very nice. Once you've made the right side.
Exactly.
Yeah. So how many years have you been coming here to fly the comp?
This is my third year in a row, and then I came in 2015 also. So this is my fourth competition and third year in a row.
Nice, because people keep coming back and learning, because this area isn't you just appear and you do well. I think it... How long have you been flying here at your home?
17 years.
Already?
Yes.
Okay, nice.
I'm old enough.
Morning from Valle de Bravo. This is task 5, and as every morning we are driving up the mountain at 8 a.m. with a smile on our faces, because we may fly on a day where there is in many countries over the world non-flyable winter time. With many spectators around, this 92 kilometers task represented the second longest run in the competition. If you want to fly a big distance, you should consider stepping on the gas from time to time. Manuel and Josh Cohn were the first to finish the day, and we met Josh for an interview later.
Top pilots here in the comp have been coming here a few times already, more or less. Josh Cohn, Josh, how many years have you been coming over here for?
Almost every year since 97.
Awesome.
So
this could be, oh no,
20
no.
20 or so years.
Almost 25 years anniversary soon. Celebrate something. So why do you keep coming back to Bahia?
It's consistently good flying and great people and food and nice town.
Okay. Because where you come from, you've got quite good flying during the winter time as well, or?
Not very good.
No?
No. The winter half of the year, there's not so much flying in the San Francisco area.
Bye. buddy, how is it going? Yeah, the last day here now at the Monaco Open, and so we just arrived to watch you guys doing your last task here.
Yeah,
we have some chances on the podium. I didn't follow it up. No. Live tracking was a little bit so-so.
Yeah, I think yesterday I got rid of my chances for the podium. But that happens.
Yeah.
You know?
But you had some great flying, you know, six days in a row and everything.
Great flying. I've been flying here for over 20 years, and I've never seen a strong east wind like we've had this comp. It seems like every day, strong east wind, so it's kind of changed everything, made it different all of a sudden. I thought I knew the place, but I'm like, man, I don't know the place.
Mm. It's the story of your life, I've heard.
Kind of changed everything.
Yeah. So, but a lot of US boys are here, I saw. Mm-hmm. Right? So it's more like a US Nationals. Yeah.
We use the Monarca as part of our national series.
You do. Okay.
And so it counts towards our national ranking and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So a lot of people come for it. And also it's a great way to get away from the cold and the snow and go flying.
Plus,
it's always amazing. Even with strong east wind, we fly every day. It's pretty incredible. You don't get up, you don't look at your computer to check the weather, you just look outside and it's like you just plan on flying every day.
That's it, yeah, therefore we are also here because it's definitely a very unique place.
No? Yeah.
The last run of the Monaco Open kicked off an hour later than the previous days, and with clouds building, this might have been a score-altering decision for many. With the clouds blocking the sun, the pilots first needed to shift gears down quite a bit. Before showers to the left and showers to the right made following the direct line a complex challenge. With no pilots in goal, the distance points were like a wild night out in Vegas, with shuffling end results around like a poker game. Dominic from Switzerland won the day in the open class, while Patricia was regaining the overall lead in the women's ranking by having flown the biggest distance of the day. After six runs, these podium places are really well deserved. Patricia from Mexico wins the women's ranking, followed by Bianca from the US and Eva from Germany. Stefano from Valle de Bravo wins the overall category, with Matt Hansey from the US coming in second and Josh Cohn, also from the USA, ranking third. Finally, in the nations ranking, the USA are taking home the title, while the Norwegians are scored second and Mexico settles on third place.